Welcome, everybody.
Hi.
Oh, jeez.
What are we playing?
I'm playing Knights of the Old Republic.
Do you know what you're playing?
No. I don't know what I'm doing anymore. Anyway, oh, boy.
It's freaky, dude.
So, welcome to the first episode of...
Offbeat Games.
Offbeat Games. My name is Kale.
I'm Becca.
And, fucking welcome.
Great start.
We're keeping this really, really casual. First episode out, so we're just gonna...
a little dust.
We're just gonna roll with it and see what happens. I figured now would be a good time to just say, like, comment and subscribe.
Yes.
If you want.
Off to a great start.
If you want, you don't have to.
We're going to be talking about games and music at the end.
Yes, we're both music nerds. We met doing musical, and
I think you want to do a new game.
Well, you don't know that. So we're just gonna get into it.
And I'm guessing this is gonna be one of your favorite games. Kale has never played this before.
I've never played it. I love Star Wars. I actually have a
big Star Wars tattoo.
I have a tattoo on my right arm of Kylo Ren's saber going through a stormtrooper helmet.
I'll put up a picture of it.
With some lightning shats, which is pretty cool. Okay.
So this is like super like D&D.
Okay.
So you can pick a class. And you can pick a gender.
This is already too many options.
So, yeah. Are you overwhelmed?
A little bit. Okay.
Could be a scout or a scoundrel.
Oh, my.
Or a soldier.
Well, so, I think I want to be more like what I actually am, so I'm just going to...
A scoundrel? Yeah. That sounds about right.
I want to be a piece of shit.
Not like you aren't already.
Exactly.
Okay, so you can make your own character.
We're gonna customize this.
Yeah,
shit.
Do it. Be vaguely Chinese guy.
Vaguely Asian. That'd be a good band name.
Also vaguely Asian guy.
Vaguely Asian.
Vaguely Asian would be a great band name. Can we name... Wait, we already have a name for our band.
Well, we're also not Asian.
We're the Eternal Blue Flames. So we were playing Breath of the Wild
the
other day.
I have Breath of the Wild and she doesn't, and it's a massive point of contention.
And I've been going over to his house as much as humanly possible to play it.
It's been a massive point of contention between the two of us. Here's a weird looking dude. Jeez. These guys look like blocks of cheese that gained sentience. look at this shit. He actually looks
relatively
decent. Normal.
Okay.
Ugh.
He looks like a businessman.
All right, we're going with it.
Okay.
He looks like a piece
Perfect.
Of shit.
Attributes.
Attributes apply bonuses or penalties to everything.
Yeah,
it's
an RPG.
We know how that fucking works.
So, yeah, you know.
Wisdom.
This is D&D, basically.
Yeah, it is.
They even got, like, modifiers and shit. Oh, it's totally D&D.
That's awesome.
Which is another game we both love.
We do.
Going to do a campaign, but that's just not happening.
No.
We're busy people.
We are. We'll up the strength.
Doing some strength.
A good amount.
That sounds good.
Do some,
do intelligence. Make him a smart guy.
Dexterity.
You have 21 points, dude.
Yeah. Constitution. I don't even know what the fuck that is.
That would be like health. Health is good to
oh,
have.
Oh shit. Well then yeah.
That's like health and defense.
Let's bring that up.
Pretty
good. Wisdom up by one. I don't want him to be two. And the rest of the points on charisma.
He's quite charismatic.
Yes. He needs to be.
Does he?
Fucking scoundrel.
What I don't even remember. What do scoundrels do?
Han Solo.
Is it Han Solo?
Yes, basically.
Okay.
Basically, what that is on the strength.
I've completely forgotten. I've had two characters in this, but.
Wait, why is Constitution higher than Charisma? That's bullshit.
Also, if you hear any sounds in the background, I'm house sitting for two, for my parents' friends, and they have two dogs. And I wouldn't feel comfortable locking them in the basement or something.
It's all right.
They're just chilling.
It's all right. They're cute.
They're adorable.
They get a pass.
And Kale loves them.
Well, it's nice to have a dog that actually likes me. So.
Yeah. Tell everyone about Goldie. Oh,
God. So I have a dog. Well, my parents have a dog named Goldie. She's half golden, half corgi.
And she's adorable.
And she's... Yes, she is. She's a rescue, so, like... It's, like, sad that she's, like, messed up in the head, but at the same time, it's like, fucking, come on.
She's a very interesting character.
She's a handful of monkeys.
Yeah, she won't, like, come anywhere near you unless Kale's mom is home.
That's true.
And that's it. She'll be fine.
Yeah, then she'll be great.
It's very strange.
I don't even know what the fuck I'm looking at. I looked at stealth, and I was like, I know what that is. I'll just... bulk up on that.
So you can hack computers.
Yeah.
It's like,
Oh, I already...
I don't know what I'm saying.
Alright, so...
What game am I thinking of that has all this? You can hack computers... Oh, I was thinking of Deus Ex, actually.
Oh, perfect.
Because I've been playing that recently. One of my favorite games. You can hack computers, you can... I don't even remember what the other, like, you can repair, like, turrets to, like, kill the enemies and stuff. It's really cool.
Oh, that's cool.
Treat injury is also a great one to have. Feats. It's.
Feats allow
it's,
you to.
It's Dungeons and Dragons.
Feats allow you
it's
to.
Like a spe- it's like a to have, So those are the ones you get.
To wear shoes.
To wear shoes. Clever.
Thank you. That's the kind of comedic excellence you can expect from Mafia Beat Games, ladies and gentlemen. All right.
We've been planning this for 3 months. I really hope it goes okay.
Yeah, we'll be fine.
So those are the ones you have. So you can click the grayed out ones.
Okay.
And you have to hit add feet. You can't just hit okay. Now you have 5 feet.
I have 5 feet. I'm going to need a lot of shoes.
Yeah, it's rather unfortunate.
Let's do...
Empathy.
No, fuck empathy. Who cares? Empathy, flurry.
So the ones lower down are, like, more your abilities.
Attack. I like that.
Yeah.
What?
What? You have no more remaining feats.
No.
No feats left.
Do I get more feats
later?
Yeah. Oh, okay.
When you level up.
Okay, cool. Perfect.
You also get, I don't want to spoil it, but you also get Jedi powers.
Oh, of course. Jack Bell. How would you give us the most stereotypical just white boy name?
White boy action hero name. Jack Bell. Oh,
jeez.
What do you want to call him?
Jack Bell. He has a troubled past of working at Taco Bell, and that's how they got his name. Oh, okay.
That makes sense.
This
is always the hardest part for us. Come on, it better be good. The audience is expecting.
Well, we only provide the best in fucking comedic entertainment.
Oh.
Lin-Manuel.
Oh, of course.
Miranda. All right, Lin. Are you ready?
This.
You're gonna be a fucking scoundrel.
Hit the play button.
All right, hold on. Well,
where it says play, hold on. You can't go back.
Oh fuck!
He's Lin-Manuel Miranda forever.
All right. Well, there. All right. We're
it's
gonna
perfect.
Be. This is actually gonna be the story of how he wrote Hamilton.
Yep, a long time ago.
A long time ago in a galaxy far, far away.
Lin-Manuel Miranda
was born.
Yay! It's Star Wars.
It's Star Wars. I just recently got the Rogue One Blu-ray.
Yeah.
And I've watched it about 3 times.
Of course.
Ever since, and it's the fucking best.
Yeah. So you've played a lot of the sequel to not the sequel. Isn't it set in the same universe? The Star Wars RPG?
Oh, the MMO?
Yeah.
Yes. It's I believe so.
Cause it has this dude in it. I don't remember what his name is.
I know which one you're
talking about. Yeah. The
it
guy
was Malik.
Malik. Yeah, that's the one.
Darth Malik is there. And you, like, I think you kill him at some point.
Oh yeah, spoilers.
Well, I mean, I have no idea. I haven't gotten to the, I haven't gotten to the end because okay.
Oh yeah, we hit the level cap.
That game is fucking, like, it's so good, and it's so interesting because you're like in the world and you're like living in the Star Wars world. Oh, there's plot. Read it, whatever. So like,
we don't care about the plot.
Who cares? It's Star Wars. Great. Fucking dark side, light side, whatever. So like, I hit the level cap, and it was like,
yeah, when I was there, that was the first time we hung out.
Yeah, when you were there, and I was like, it was like, well, if you like upgraded your subscription from free to play to something, I was like, wait. So it wouldn't let me finish the game until I paid money.
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh my god, it was so stupid.
I just realized we haven't been like timing this at all.
Whatever.
I'll just start a stopwatch now.
Perfect. Hey, this ship
Space
is fucked.
Space battles! Yay! So what is your favorite Star Wars movie?
Oh.
As a huge Star Wars nerd. Geez. I have to put you on the spot. Oh look, you look great.
Hold on. Wake up, Lynn. You have a writing deadline in a week.
Oh, shit, man.
Oh, fuck.
We should have picked, like, a... Stop it!
Relax. This came off naturally. It's fine.
Kale just got a new tattoo, and he keeps scratching it.
It's...
Pay attention. There's plot going
it's
on.
It's fine.
Lin-Manuel Miranda has to save
the
world.
Wow, yeah, we've been fucking... All right.
Yeah, left click to select it. I don't know if you could figure that out by yourself.
Yeah, I have no idea how mice work.
Trask Ulgo. I love the names in Star Wars.
I love how
the
they give you, like, fucking Matt Smith, and they give this guy Trask Ulgo. Like,
yep. So the ship is crashing, and we have to find Bastila, who is a... Spoilers, she's a Jedi.
Oh, cool.
Forget it, I'm looking after my own skin. What kind of character are you going to be making?
I'm going to be an asshole.
Of course you are.
I'm going to be the opposite of Lin-Manuel Miranda.
You're going to be Kale Singleton.
Yes, I'm going to be me. Kale Singleton is Lin-Manuel Miranda as a fucking Star Wars alien.
Perfect. What's going on? Writing skills.
Wow, fuck you. Bringing up my past.
You've got, like, he's got quite the man boob.
He does. It's, I mean, and, like, he's supposed to be jacked, so you wouldn't think.
Yeah.
Oh, then, oh, I'm heading to the escape us. Fuck you!
Yeah, I mean, you're just a scrub. You're not a Jedi.
Man, whatever.
You just got a gun, and that's it.
Okay.
Okay. Oh man, we were just talking about this. This is one of my pet peeves in games, where they describe what you're supposed to be doing in voiceover.
That's right.
It's,
yeah, it's terrible.
I don't like it.
It just takes you out of the game.
Yeah, it takes you out of it so much.
It makes you think just like, oh yeah, I'm playing a video game.
Yeah. In case you needed a reminder, you are playing a video game.
Mm-hmm.
You can left click.
God.
Shut up!
Can you repeat
that, please? What is this, Zelda?
Wait, are we in a video game? Okay.
Oh, you look great.
We're playing.
Look at that ass. It's got a nice ass.
I guess so, yes.
So, we're playing the game.
All right, here we go. Wait, how do I open?
Amazing. You got some shit? Get items?
Hey,
I think you can hit I to go into your inventory because
it's
an MMO. Or not an MMO. It's an RPG. So there's your stuff.
Blaster pistol. Well,
I think it might.
You
have to go to the first one. So that's all the things you can get.
Oh, okay.
And you need to equip some from there.
Let's do the fucking
pistol. Yeah. I figured.
Fuck yeah.
Some clothing. Because you weren't wearing any before.
Clearly, yeah. No.
So you can have two weapons, but they have to be, you know, one-handed.
Yeah.
Because RPGs. You don't have anything else. You don't.
Can I just...
No.
Let me live my life.
No.
Hey, look at that.
There we go. fine.
What did I just say?
He's trying joined to be your party.
I don't care. Fuck him. He woke me up.
You, Trask.
From my nap.
Oh, good.
Use me. Just use me. All right.
How do I use you to unlock the door?
Tell me exactly what to do.
Tell me exactly what you want me to do.
Please, slowly.
Oh, man. So you can be different people.
Okay.
You don't just have to be Lin-Manuel Miranda. Oh,
thank God.
I mean, what an asshole, right?
Yeah, seriously.
Stop it!
That's the only way I can itch it.
It's gonna Okay, as an explanation, he's hitting his arm because he can't itch his tattoo.
I can't itch my tattoo. You can't
it
full
sounds
on
like
itch.
You're slapping someone.
No, they know. We just said. It's fine.
Not everyone has tattoos, Kale.
Well, then we'll just explain why, and then they'll be good.
Okay, well, I just did.
So, yeah.
Why are you talking to him again? Click on his portrait down there. And you're him now.
Oh, jeez.
And now you can open the door. Now switch back to Lin-Manuel Miranda. You did it. Good job.
Thank you. I feel very accomplished.
Oh, in case you didn't know, you can also use...
Wait, hold on.
S-W-C-Z?
S-W-C-Z. S-W...
Yeah, you don't... Does that work? Oh, hello.
Well,
hey, man.
Hey, it's the singer from Waves. What's up, man?
The singer from Waves?
He looks like the singer from Waves.
I will take your word for it.
Oh, my God. You need to listen to more music.
I know. I'm a little behind in terms of music.
So
I
if
guess.
I'm like, if I'm having to explain jokes a lot, that's
it's
why.
Because I'm an idiot and I just don't like. I just play video games all day. I'm sorry.
That's fine.
I've been better at listening to music.
That's fine.
Since I met you.
Yeah.
Yeah, we met like half a year ago, maybe?
Half a year ago now, yeah.
We were both in Pippin together.
Yeah. It was a fun time.
This guy was the star, and I was a person who sang and danced sometimes.
Sometimes. Oh, yeah, I upgraded security so I can actually get through doors. So I don't even need him. He's essentially useless.
Well, I mean...
I'm standing right here.
Okay, so this is... Okay, so when you... This is kind of important. So when you encounter enemies, it'll pause. And then you have to click what you want to do. So that's... Yeah. So you have a little thingy here that'll tell you all the actions you're going to take.
Cool.
You click the three buttons. You don't click the dude. You don't have those yet. That's like bombs and stuff. So that's your special attack, and then you can hit down arrow, too.
Okay.
And then spacebar to unpause.
Cool.
There you go.
Ah, Jesus.
Doing great. So then you have to keep doing it, because this is like your hot bar,
I
guess.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Makes sense.
Okay.
Makes sense. We're figuring it out, y'all.
He died!
Fuck him. Whatever.
You're an asshole, dude.
Everyone should know right now that when
I play
video games, I like usually like when shit like that happens, I'm not usually the one who's like, "Oh, that's so sad." I'm just like, "Fucking good."
Oh yeah.
Not if like I'm seeing like atrocities take place, like then I'm a little less like ugh.
So that's your special move. You could also hit the down arrow to do like a normal attack.
Eh.
You have multiple powers. But your thing is full, so just hit space.
Yeah, that's fine.
Doing great. Sir, excuse me.
You are right in my
right there.
I will not be held responsible if you get shot. Alright. He steps
entirely
right
his
in
fault.
Fucking front of me.
Oh, he's fine. It's okay. All right. So you can also search some of the buddies.
Okay.
And the footlockers. Got some swords and a grenade.
Frag grenade. Frag out.
Yeah.
Oh, can I tell you a funny story?
No.
Too bad.
Okay.
So, when I was in high school, I was in a production of Les Miserables.
Were you?
I was.
I didn't know this.
Yeah.
What'd you play?
I played Andra.
Oh, yeah, I did know this.
And it was
you
super fun
this.
And great. shout out to CG. So remains. It's not even a person. It's just remains now.
It says container is empty. He's just a container now. It's fine.
We're all just gut containers. Anyway.
That's deep.
So that's deep.
We're all just gut containers in the end, guys. Just gut
containers.
You gonna open that door?
Yeah, I will. So I played Andra. Hold on. Plot.
Oh, it's whoa. Fine. They're
cyborg ninjas.
Yeah.
Whoa, they're frame very rate drop.
It's fine. I have a shitty computer.
This is awesome.
They're very golden.
They're like super. Like, it's like the Empire was like, do you know what shows real power? Gold. Everything must be
everything
gold.
Everything must be gold. So, Les Mis.
So, in Les Mis, there are a couple barricade scenes.
You can use grenade too.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
I will do that then. So. When, oh, okay.
You just cleared it.
That's fine.
That's what that does.
So in Les Mis, there are a bunch of battle scenes. And, when we were rehearsing the battle scenes, we were, of course, all just, like, idiots about it.
Of course.
So we used, like, Call of Duty methodology. So in rehearsal, for, like, 18-something France. We were on stage. This is like tech rehearsals and stuff. Because they were like, just yell things that people would yell in battles. And we're like, okay.
Oh, no.
So you can't give high schoolers that amount of freedom. So we just go, we start just being like, frag out! AC-130 inbound! And like, one of my friends was like, planting claymore. And he ran off the barricade, went to the ground, and, like, planted a claymore and ran back.
No.
Like, oh, it was so fucking funny. We're just laughing our asses off.
Please tell
time.
Me you did not do that during the show.
No, of course not. We're professionals at Caregrove.
Oh, well, I don't know. High schoolers?
We're pro at Caregrove. Excuse me.
Oh, whatever.
I will not.
I didn't go to Caregrove. I also didn't.
Oh, I'm like almost dead.
Oh yeah. Hey.
I realized.
I think those are. Yeah.
Oh. Fantastic.
I'm sorry. I completely forgot how to play this game.
I didn't realize. I just saw him like holding. I was like, am I hurt? And I looked down at my health bar. I'm like, yeah. I have no health.
You got parts.
Sweet.
Just some, you know.
So humans become
unspecific parts.
So humans become remains when they die, and robots become
parts
piles when they die.
I mean, I don't.
There's totally Jedi behind this door.
Yeah, I don't think you can go that way.
I don't think so.
Strangely enough.
Oh well.
Wait! Look out the windows. Are those windows? Oh, you can see stars. Oh, and ships.
Oh, that's barfy.
It's barfy.
That's barfy.
Yeah, you get really barfy.
I do. It's just a thing.
Like, what were we playing? Was that Breath of the Wild?
No. No, it wasn't Breath of the Wild. It was...
Oh, Skyrim!
It was
when
Skyrim,
when you went up
yeah.
into the, like... When you went up into the sky during that one quest.
Oh, no, that was like Vertigo. Like, so when...
Oh, look at this dude.
When environments are, like, super detailed and I'm falling, and or there's, like, a big pit underneath me, I get, like, the little, like... I don't even know how to describe it. It's, like, just, like, a little, like, catch
like
in your
nausea.
Chest. It's not even nausea. It's just like you just feel like, I don't know. You just like feel like a little lift in your chest, like as if you were falling.
I've never I've not experienced that.
No, yeah, it's really weird. So yeah, I like we were up. It was during the quest where fuck.
You got this.
You return the woman's orb to her temple, and it's a bunch of light rays going through doors
yeah.
and shit. So when she takes
it's
like you,
Azura. It's
think,
one of the
so,
like goddesses.
Yeah, it's one of the Daedra lords. So she like takes you up into the air.
Yeah, yeah.
Just randomly talk to you. And then you fall. And every time it did that, it felt like I was, like, falling because the environment was so detailed.
That's very strange.
Yeah, so it's really weird. So, yeah, when I'm in, like, a moving ship or vessel in a video game and... Or I'm in a stationary ship and everything around me is moving, I get, like, super weird. It's not all the time, but it's, like, a decent amount of time.
Oh, yeah, you can also change his equipment.
Oh, okay, cool. What if they have a lightsaber, though? That could hurt.
Yeah, probably.
Don't be a pussy!
It might hurt a little.
Just shoot them. I mean, what can they do? You're shooting them. Thank you.
Yeah. Stop talking!
Oh, God. Okay.
I don't like him. She needs to shut the fuck up.
Whoa! Oh my God.
Hello, everyone! My name's Lin-Manuel Miranda!
Can I play you guys a new mixtape I'm working on? It's this little thing called Hamilton, and I think you'll love it.
Yeah, it's a little bit niche.
A little bit.
I don't know if everyone's gonna like it.
A little bit niche. That's hilarious. Oh God, I'm dying. Ah!
You used like four!
I'm not gonna. It's okay.
You can level up too. Once you kill these assholes.
Kill these fuckwits.
Fuckwit.
These
ooh.
Fuckwits.
You should also probably like equip a better weapon. I think you have one.
Oh, it's fine.
Oh, it's whatever. We'll just play with this gun. Stop talking! So they're trying to capture the Jedi lady.
Okay.
Go level up. So I feel better about my life.
Hold on. All right.
You okay?
Yes. Level up.
So you get some skills. Do some skills. Let's see. What are good ones? Treat injuries, probably a good one to have.
Persuade.
Wow, I almost forgot how to say that word. I was like, oh yeah, persuade.
You said it so wrong, I just assumed that was right.
Persuade is a good one. Computer use and repair. And security is actually really good.
Okay.
You have a lot of stealth, man.
Eh.
I've never once used stealth in this game.
I'm all about stealth.
I know you
Let's
are.
Let's do security and
repair.
What?
Okay, so calm.
What the fuck?
Depending on what, like, class you chose, some of the skills cost 1 point to get, and some of the skills cost 2 points.
Got ya.
You can mouse down. There's more skills, feats.
What?
There's more feats.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, there's a lot. There's a lot.
I think I've used that.
Plus 5 damage to the next attack, but also -3 to hit.
Oh, I don't like that.
This is very D&D, and I love it.
Dueling. Let me see. Power attack. Just -3 to a hit. I don't like that. It's like this does a ton of damage, but then it doesn't do shit.
Yeah. It either does a lot or nothing.
Cares in front damage is 3 seconds.
Yeah. That's heavy armor.
Well, as a character, wear heavy armor.
Wookiees and droids cannot wear heavy armor.
Thank God I'm not a Wookiee then.
Oh God.
That'd be hilarious.
I just thought of
if Chewbacca was in the leading role of Hamilton, because that's where my mind went.
No, that's not what I was thinking of. Oddly enough, I was thinking of that one Star Wars game we played, where you called me a Wookiee racist.
What?
You don't remember that?
No!
I don't remember what you were playing. You used to play it all the time with your friends.
Battlefront?
When you were little, yeah.
Battlefront 2?
Maybe. I don't know.
Oh my God. I, like, vaguely remember you saying something to the effect of, like... You said, like, I hate Wookiees or something. I was like, geez, racist.
I was like...
Or you said something.
I love their planet, but, like, I would love to live on the planet where there weren't, like... Without the Wookiees there.
Oh, yeah.
Something like that.
Like, I'd love to live on the planet.
Wookiee racist.
You were like, I'd love to live on the planet as long as there weren't any Wookiees there. I was like, what? That doesn't make any sense. See, like this. Like, look at this.
You're really not doing well.
It's just like, huh. I'm doing, like, okay right now. But it's just like, even just like looking
at
it.
No, I mean, like, the ship isn't doing well. No, yeah. We're just like, we should be falling extremely fast, I feel like. I don't know how space works.
I don't know.
What?
All right, Trask.
I don't know how space works. So we've been going longer than 20 minutes.
This is off the thing. Okay.
Do we want to talk about our album?
About the album we listened to before the episode?
So, our plan with this is to kind of talk about the game for a while, and then at the end, Kale had no idea what I was
right,
going
right,
there.
Right, 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 okay, I remember how our show works now. Fuck. Go, I'm voice acting.
Oh, anyway, that walk.
Good lord. Anyway, continue.
So, at the end of the episode, we're going to talk about an album.
It could be any album. Yeah. You know, we both have really kind of an eclectic music taste.
Definitely.
I mean, I don't want to say, like, especially me, but, like...
It is true.
Especially me. Because, like, I, you know, I listen to, I can go from listening to Kendrick Lamar to Rush...
Hamilton.
To Waves to Hamilton and many other cast albums as well. So, I mean, you know, our music taste is very varied. So... What's up, singer from Waves, and so it's him. Like, it looks just like
okay,
him. He's
I'm
even got the hair exactly like that. So we want to just kind of just talk about music. You know, we won't get too far into it because we don't want to talk about anything that we don't know. So that way we're not...
Well, we do want to talk about stuff we don't know.
But... Well, yes, but I just mean with, like, you know, if we don't know about, like, production what good production sounds like as opposed to bad production, like, we don't want to, like, bullshit and be like, oh, it's so, like, well-produced in the way that, like, the mix, you know, like, we don't just want to, like, spew nonsense.
Right. But our plan is to talk about an album at the end of every episode, so if you have any suggestions for things you want us to listen to, you can send us an email, and I will put the email up.
Yes, please.
So yeah, you can do that, but for this first episode, we decided to talk about the thing that brought us together as friends, which was the Pippin soundtrack. Aww. Aww.
How adorable.
So, where do you want to start with that one?
So, I was gonna say something.
Here, I made a list.
Oh, perfect.
I took notes because I'm a nerd, and I wrote down all the.
We're goddamn professionals.
Oh, guys. It's not even in here.
We are goddamn
Where
professionals.
Is it? I think I would have taken it out of my bag.
It's not here. We don't have it.
I actually wrote it on the back of the Pippin thing that she gave us the first day.
Oh my god.
I took notes and I wrote down all the titles, all the names and stuff.
We're coming so full circle, you guys.
It's incredible.
Right.
So I we could just go in order.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
A
little background.
Yeah, Kale, explain the plot of Pippin if people,
I remember what it is.
I would really hope. He played Pippin, by the way.
I was the title character.
It was
an incredible honor. And, you know, Pippin is one of those shows where, like, you know, you have title characters. I know. There we go.
Yeah.
So, like, you have title characters that, like, don't do a whole lot, or it's, like, you know, they'll have, like, bit parts. Like in Heathers. Like, the actual Heathers...
He was in Heathers, too.
I was in Heathers, too.
You played J.D.?
J.D., yeah. Yes.
I haven't seen Heathers.
It's incredible. If you haven't listened to Heathers or seen Heathers, find it. Go see a community show. The rights just got released, so everyone's doing it. Ah. So, go see it.
You can't go that way.
So, like, in Heathers, like, the title characters... oh, thank you. I should probably go there.
Probably. Map note, escape pods.
Thank you.
Okay, so Pippin.
So, usually title characters, well, not usually, but sometimes the title characters aren't, like, super, like, kind of out in front.
Oh, like Hamilton.
Like Hamilton. So, but, like, for this, I'm completely... I was on stage for pretty much the entire show,
and it was
super daunting. You know, I'm a tenor, like, I've done shows before, but this was, you know, this was a show that I didn't know a whole lot about. I just knew the music was damn good.
It is damn good.
But I didn't really know that much about it, so going in, I was very nervous. So it was an incredible honor to be able to do it and to be able to pull it off well enough to feel like I actually did a good job. So anyway, the show.
Magic to Do is the first one. Oh, wait, you were gonna explain the plot.
I went off on a tangent and fucking...
That's okay. That's why we're doing a show.
Yes. So the story is about Pippin. Shock. Really? Surprise.
Yeah.
Spoiler alert, it's about Pippin. It's about a young prince who has had pretty much everything given to him his entire life, and he decides that it isn't good enough. I can't do this.
Okay, so let me just really quick.
Sorry. Had to take care of the dogs, and...
they were freaking out. Reactivate the droid.
It's all good.
So these all cost repair parts. So you can activate the shields, or make them patrol... So if they patrol, they'll start shooting your enemies.
Okay. I like that.
It's pretty good.
Sweet. I'll just leave it on after that.
All right. So, Pippin.
So it's essentially about a guy who has everything, and, you know, he's determined that that's not good enough for him. So he goes out to find meaning in life and find kind of his purpose. As we said, the music in it is amazing.
It's incredible. It's Stephen Schwartz,
Stephen Schwartz,
who did
Wicked and Godspell. So he's a fucking genius.
He's incredible.
He actually wished us luck on our production.
Oh yeah, because
our set dude
met him.
Met him and said he was really nice. He said we were opening that weekend, and he was like, "Well, good luck to you guys."
That's so sweet.
Hope you do really well. So he was really nice, and it was written in the 70s. It was his first musical, and it's so good.
And it had a revival recently.
Yes.
When was that?
That was, I think it was like 3 years ago or something. The original role of leading player
was Ben Vereen. Right?
Was Ben Vereen, who is a fucking legend. Beast. If you can find, which I think you still can,
on YouTube.
Yeah,
there is the entire
Broadway cast with
Ben Vereen and
William Catt
as
Pippin. And it's just an incredible show.
It is definitely
Ben Vereen is an absolute beast and is insane. And he was replaced by the equally incredibly talented and insane Patina Miller. So it's the first time that the leading player was ever a woman, and she...
is incredible.
Just destroyed.
Yes.
I'm the lead singer of Waves. Yeah, we get it. Sith is bad.
Yep.
Whatever.
Okay.
We're just gonna talk about the show that we.
Yeah, we should probably get on that.
Yes, we should. I'm sorry.
You're rambling.
I am.
Okay.
I have a tendency to do that.
To start off, the first song is "Magic to Do," which is
one of it's one of the greatest. Oh, jeez. Sorry. Hey, Lynn, we need to just back up just a little bit. All right, over here. Am I good right here? you know what? Yeah, we're fine. You know, we're just going to roll with that.
It's okay.
We're going to roll with that.
That's really weird. I've never seen him.
Yeah.
So, okay, the problem with talking about this show is that every single song I'm going to be saying, this is my favorite song.
We'll get to that.
Okay, so Magic To Do.
So Magic To Do is considered one of the greatest opening numbers of all time. And there's very, very good reason for that. It's just this...
smoky. Smoky is the word I always use.
Yes. It's this... it starts with... also, we're going to be talking about the Revival album.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, mostly.
A little bit of both.
Yeah, because our production was kind of a fusion between the two.
It was. There was a 2007, I think, revision of it.
Oh.
Because the new... version of it hasn't been released yet for some reason. I'm still waiting on it.
That's weird.
I really want that album to get released.
Magic to do. Focus.
It's amazing. It starts with just this...
Yeah, just the little...
This little just like organ thing kind of comes in, and it's this... it just kind of leads into this little, like, piano riff.
Which is so catchy.
It's so good. And it's just, it starts very, very subtle.
It's really foreboding, actually.
It is.
The little choir.
Yeah. It really makes you think, like, it's like, oh, that's kind of creepy.
Yeah.
And then, like, the leading player comes in and starts singing, and it you know, join us. Leave your field to flower. And it's just very, like... He sings it in such, like, a sweet way.
Yeah, it kind of...
It, like, puts you at ease.
Yeah, and, like, once the chorus comes in, it's, like, all, you know, major and happy. Also, as a side note, I'm a music major, so I might be using big words sometimes. I'm sorry. I just know a lot about music. You wanna pick a dream... Right, I'm Lin-Manuel Miranda, by the way.
I wrote such hits as In the Heights and Hamilton.
I performed for President Barack Obama. What did I write? I love the dance break in Magic To Do.
Yes.
It really reminds me of Cats.
It's very much in that vein.
Yeah.
It's just so... Energetic and fun, it's just wonderful.
Yeah, one of my standout memories is like from doing the show is just the first show. I was terrified because I've never done a musical or anything before besides like just singing on stage for choirs and stuff. So like one of my clearest memories is just standing backstage, like looking up at Tony, who was our leading player. At the, like, on the top of the stage and, like, seeing his silhouette against the spotlight. It was just so cool. I loved it.
Everything about that number and as well as that, just, like, the whole show is just very stylized and cool. There's just this, like, unbelievable amount of cool in it.
And like, quirky.
The leading player is so smooth and so just... like awesome. I don't know. Like it just there's so much about it that's just so cool to look at.
You should probably be playing the game, Kale.
It's fine.
We should actually probably end this episode.
Alright. We'll come back.
We will come back and talk about Pippin.
Thanks for tuning in and watching
Bearing with us
on this first episode of Offbeat Games.
Yeah,
thank you guys. We'll be back.
We'll see you soon.
See you soon. Bye.
Bye.